Hey guys, SlySonic7 here, and today we're going to be actually going back to a playlist that I think that people thought was going to be completely done because the new NBA 2K came out. So we're actually on NBA 2K16 now, and what we're going to do is we're going to try to continue the My GM mode that we started in NBA 2K15. Now, since they haven't built in a functionality of how I can actually carry on my team from 2015, what we're going to do is start over with a brand new team, but just continue the series overall. But what I found is that if you look at actually the custom rosters that are online, you look at this top one on here, the Legends Throwback Prime. I'm gonna select this. What's gonna end up happening is that we actually get to have a fantasy draft now, but with all of the legends. So Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Michael Jordan, Charles Barkley, like Oscar Robertson. Why was Charles Barkley one of the top three names that I mentioned? It's things like that that it's going to be really cool to have, and then you combine it with, obviously, your very good players. One thing they also do that's really cool is that they take your really great NBA players that are still in the league, so like Tim Duncan, Kobe Bryant, Dwayne Wade, and LeBron, and they give you younger, more prime versions of them that you can actually use. So this will be a really fun fantasy draft. So we're going to select this. As far as the team that we're actually going to be representing this year, I haven't made up my mind. Last year we did the Celtics, and I'm kind of on the opinion that maybe let's just keep it up. But I'm thinking of just holding on the right trigger. So I'm going to close my eyes right now, and we're going to see what we land on. So I'm going to count down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, the Memphis Grizzlies. All right, Memphis Grizzlies, they never won anything, so let's see if they do it now. I like to randomize the owner personality, so if you press square a couple times, I want to give him a level of patience that's pretty high. And the team success, team image, that's good. Money doesn't care, and involvement doesn't care. That's perfect. This is the perfect one I want, because I don't want the owner to be very involved in anything. He is very big on franchise morale, though, so we need to make sure we can balance out all the players. So here we go. So we're going to press advance. And now it's all about what pick we are in this draft. So we're not high, I can tell that. So if you see Prime Kareem, Prime Kobe, Prime Duncan, Michael Jordan are all going. Amazingly enough, I ran this a few times. Michael Jordan goes fourth every time, which just blows my mind because I feel like 99 MJ should probably be going first. Let's see how far down we are. Grizzlies. Shit, we're far down. Holy shit. I think we're actually at the very bottom, aren't we? Jerry West, Karl Malone, Prime Shaq, Prime Dwayne Wade, Hakeem, David Robinson, Allen Iverson. And this is the cool part, is that you see like all of these like, you know, just great names. Okay, so here we go. So now it's finally our pick. We have a hard choice here, honestly. And one thing I'm going to do that's going to be a little bit counterintuitive is I'm really going to care about the contract. Because it's great and all to say that, oh, I have these like legends. Like my favorite one to pick here is this 94 Steve Nash who just shoots perfect threes and is perfect from the line and everything like that. But he has a one-year deal, which means that the second the season's over, I can't really continue with 94 Steve Nash, which kind of sucks if you really think about it. So it's like, it's great to have a great guy, but like you want to make sure you can actually enjoy the guy for at least a year or two here. So like Moses Malone, great, can't have him. Trace McGrady would be awesome, but again, can't have him. So it's like, you're kind of sitting there like, well, what do I do? For that reason, I have a hard choice here, man. Oh, do I take Steph Curry, who's sucking a deal for nothing right now? I'm the 20th pick, which means by the time it comes back around, Curry will most likely would not be available. But this is a Legends draft, which means I kind of want to enjoy the Legends. So let's take Scottie Pippen. All right, Dirk got taken, Moses Malone, Steve Nash, Paul Pierce, Vince Carter, Pete Maravich, Steph Curry, gone, of course. And Kevin Durant. Coming back, we got T-Mac, Ray Allen, Wilkins, Stoudemire. I love how they have a prime Amari Stoudemire. He's sunk that much. Alright. Now, here we go. So, we just took Scottie Pippen, which means that small forwards are off limits right now, so no Carmelo, thank God. I actually made the mistake of picking Carmelo over Scotty one time here, and I realized the one thing that's really annoying about Carmelo is that he has 3 years on the contract, but he has a no-trade clause, which means that if he's not playing Walford, you can't get rid of him, which sucks. So now here we get to where we get to some of the fun ones. So we got Chris Paul, we got John Stockton, you know, one of the best point guards of all time, Gary Payton, the glove, like, there's so many great guys. I'm going to be completely honest, point guards is one of the most stacked positions, so I'm either going to pick a shooting guard or center. So center, we can take Bill Walton, which is pretty great, or Dikembe. Both of those guys would be great, and I am almost a little bit biased towards it. The one reason why I'm not and why I would love to do this is we have Reggie fucking Miller, who we can take right here. He looks nothing like Reggie Miller, by the way. Who could just rein in every three, or we could take 22-year-old Michael Jordan. Both of those are great, but if you look at this 22-year-old MJ, can't shoot threes worth shit. So, second pick, crazy enough, I don't think I've ever imagined anyone ever saying this, I'm taking Reggie Miller over Michael Jordan. So we're going to keep going. I'm a little bit interested to see where we land as far as the next center available, because I don't think it's going to be that good, but I think we really need to focus on centers. Oh, wow, that's awesome. You got Dr. J. Okay. Center. Ben Wallace or Marc Gasol? Marc Gasol has a really expensive contract. Ben Wallace has a one-year deal. Both kind of suck. This is my answer right here. Robert Parrish. Robert Parrish has a three-year deal worth nothing. I love it. I could take him or Bill Laimbeer. No, but Robert Parrish is rated better and is cost less. There we go. Robert Parrish. Taken Chief. Okay. So now we have a small forward, a shooting guard, and a center, which means we need to focus on power forward and point guard. So if we look at point guard, we still have some guys who are left over here. So you have your Mark Price, keep scrolling down, you actually have like your regular very good players. Oh, you even have Dennis Johnson, that's really cool. I really love how far back they stretched as far as getting people on here. Because it's not even just people you'd imagine. Doc Rivers, things like that. People who, like, had very good careers. Nick Van Exel, that's the best. Nick Van Exel got traded to, like, every friggin' team. So it's awesome to see him here. Right. Dr. J here is cool. But again, we have Scottie Pippen. So I need to focus somewhere else. So this is where we have a really interesting one. Is that, do I want to get Dennis Rodman, who is... I mean, frankly, one of the best power forwards who ever played. I'm pretty sure this isn't his prime one, but whatever. I mean, he's 34 in this. Chris Webber, who has 1 year left on his deal also. Tim Duncan, who has 2 years, but every time I played this, my GM with him, he retires after 1 year, so it doesn't matter if he has 2 years left. I think NBA 2K is making assumptions to what happens after the Spurs season. Elton Brand is kind of funny here, but again, like, if you start seeing that, like, we start to get a pretty big drop-off. We start dropping down here. And we start to really lose anything that's of value here. Again, I could take, like, 25-year-old Draymond, but he is such an expensive contract, and I don't really like to play him as a power forward, so, like, again, it's making our choice kind of hard here, but I think I'm gonna take Rodman. He's a little bit cheaper. He's on a one-year deal, which isn't great, but... it's whatever. So we're going to take Rodman here. And next time around here, we really need to focus on the point guard. So I saw that Mark Price just got taken. So here we go. So we take Mike Conley, which is actually pretty great if you think about it. What I really want from my point guard is two different things. I want him to have a playmaking that's in the A, and I want him to have a three-pointer that's a B plus or higher. So Mike Conley works out here, but he's a one-year deal. Derek Harper... it has A's in both of them and has a two-year deal. So, you know, I like that a little more. But let's see. Do we have anyone else who I'd be considering? Sam Cassell. How is he in this game? I love it. Okay, Sam Cassell is actually pretty good with all these. And let's see. Physical IQ, potential. Yep. Okay. This is going to be a random-ass team, but Sam Cassell, here we go. Okay, so now we gotta start working in the backups, which is, in my opinion, the most fun part about it, because it's easy when you start out to say, like, all right, I'm gonna take, you know, this good guy, this good guy, this good guy, and, you know, you work position by position. I think it's a lot harder to say, now that I got all the guys that I want, how do I build the rest of my team? So, and again, we want to be price conscious of everything we're doing here. So, let's look around here for a little bit, and I'll cut to where I think I found a guy. Alright guys, so I looked through it, And I think after deciding upon it, I think Mike Conley is actually the best choice for our backup point guard. So we're going to take him. As we're going to come back around, a lot of good guys are going to get taken here. But I have a pretty good idea in mind of who I want my next guy to be. It's all about him still being there. So let's see. All right. So one of the guys I was looking for was actually still here. So we're going to take Rudy Gobert here. So it goes against what I was saying about the idea of like signing guys who are multi-year contracts. But Gobert has come so cheap and brings such a defensive boost that I think he's just definitely worth it. So if we come back around, I'm going to go back to my original theme here, which is I want shooters. And if I want shooters, I want Kyle Korver. Kyle Korver is still 2 more years, cheap as hell. Here we go. All right, here's a pick that I love. We're going to take significantly younger Shane Battier. He's 28 years old in this one. He doesn't do anything great, but he does everything well, which is a real testament to what Shane Battier was as a player. And he's just really that Swiss Army knife you want on your team. He comes really cheap, only $3 million, so here we go. Now, last thing we need to do is get ourselves another power forward. So we're gonna take Jared Sullinger. So now we actually have backups to all of our starters. So we've been through 10 rounds. As you can see, there's still another 3 rounds to go. So really this is all about who are just the best people left. So for this one, I'm not gonna go position by position. I'm really just gonna look down this master list. And let's just see if there's anyone here who makes a lot of sense, like you could throw in. Again, the hardest part about getting someone here is that like you want them to be cheap because realistically, they're probably not gonna be playing. So Avery Bradley is a great example of that. Can play some great defense, can throw him in if someone gets injured. Cost $3 million, not a huge commitment. And if we keep looking here, again, someone like Pekovic, if he was worth $3 million, maybe, but not worth 11 or 12 like he is. That's ridiculous. Muggsy Bogues. I love it. He's 5'3". It's amazing. I just love how this guy actually made the NBA because he was just that good. 5'3", 140. Like, that is... I think I was that height and size when I was probably, like, in 7th or 8th grade. Which is just hilarious to me, just to see that like that's a professional NBA player. Which, I mean, like, again, more credit to the guy who did it, but it's just crazy. Again, Drew Gooden, cheap, never going to use the guy, here we go. And this last pick is really just going to be like positioned for left bench, like they should never get in there. Let's see, is there a calling here that is salary? No, that would be too easy. okay, so we're going to keep going down until we see contract and just see one that is like a one-year deal for nothing. Ah, there we go, Mo Williams. Perfect. Mo Williams is actually pretty funny too because you could actually use him if you really need to. So there we go. So we're going to exit the draft. And what I can frankly say is, guys, the Memphis Grizzlies look primed for championship contention. So before we finish off the video, let's meet our owner. He's going to tell us what our goals for the season are. And let's see how it goes. So my guy looks kind of weird in a sweater, in a little tuxedo vest, got a knit. All right, so how are you, Sly? I hope you're ready to get things going. He's the newest GM of the Memphis Grizzlies. Let's get right down to business. Here are my demands for the season. I don't want a general manager that makes and then breaks promises to players. If you promise something, you better follow through. So this is a huge hook because players will come to you and say, I want more minutes, I want to practice harder, I want to practice less. And you got to be careful about sometimes when you can promise things so you know, or just say that, you know, it's all for the good of the team that you're playing how you are and kind of like coddle them with tough love a little bit. So we got to keep an eye on that. I'm going to say we'll accomplish, obviously, because the owner wants to hear that. My word is stronger than oak. That is terrible. Okay. Yeah, well, I hope that's true. Kush's dad from Cherry Maguire said the same thing. Oh my god, that's awesome. Okay, I strongly believe that the key to a winning organization is happy players. Don't do anything to upset too many of our players. Keep average team morale above 60. And then we need 3 superstar players to compete for championships every season. Get us a big 3. Oh. Okay. Now, here we go. So we are the Memphis Grizzlies. As you see, we have won 0 championships in our entire illustrious career. I want to take a look really quick as to what he counts as superstars. Okay, there we go, the very top. It says all-around superstar. Reggie Miller says all-around star. And then Rodman says defensive star, two-way star for Robert Parrish, two-way star for Mike Conley, an offensive superstar for Sam Cassell. Okay, so we have different superstars. So we have two people who are called superstars. I would not count Sam Cassell as part of any big three ever, but this would be interesting. So we got to figure out a way to somehow turn this team into a group of multiple superstars. Well, our work is cut out for us, guys, but as you can see, we have a lot of ripe talent here. We actually have 8 people with a rating of 80 or better, so this is going to be great. And then the fun part is if you really want to look around the league. So yeah, I'm going to flip for a second. I just want to show you one of the most fun teams. Wow. Okay, so I think this is probably my favorite, just top to bottom. This is just a pretty stacked team. It costs a shit ton, but whatever. It's all a one-year deal team, too. So you got Prime LeBron, who's a 98, Prime Gary Payton, who's a 93, Prime Artis Gilmore, who, if people don't know, Artis Gilmore was probably one of the best scoring centers, like, outside of that whole Wilt Chamberlain era. So, I mean, amazing, as you can see, 92. You got Klay Thompson, who's an 87, Kirilenko in his prime. Oh, no, not even his prime, just 34-year-old Andre Kirilenko, who's apparently just still that good. Joakim Noah, Draymond Green, I mean, and Drew Holiday as, wow, that is just a crazy backup point guard. And then you have Goran Dragic as your third point guard. Like, it's a crazy team. Definitely going to watch out for the Spurs, so we'll see what happens. I like how even in a fantasy draft, the Spurs stay relevant. Although, I don't know how Pop's going to coach this team. There's way too much ego on it. All right. Well, guys, this has been everything for this video. In the next episode, what we're going to try to do is explore how we can make a big three before the season starts. So, guys, this has been Sly Sonic 7. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.